Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I am going to teach how to make the simple student registration system using C#.net. Let us show the demo first. Here, this is the demo. Here, this is the data grid view. Data grid view shown two buttons, edit and delete. Here, click on these two buttons and you will be able to edit and delete the record, right? This is the form which we use to add the records into the database here. So here, first I am going to register student as Peter. Course I am going to enter as C#. Fee I am going to enter as 10,000. Right. Okay. Now click save button. Record added. Click OK. And refresh it, you will be able to see the record, right? Peter C#10,000, right? Now if you want to edit the record, right, if you want to edit the record, what you are going to do is here, there will be the choice edit here, right? Click edit button, right? You can't click here as well, you can't do anything else. If you click edit button, selected record should be displayed here. Okay, if you click this one, if you click this one here, selected record should be passing to the forms successfully here, right? Now here, what I am going to do is here, I am going to change it as a C#.net. Course fee I am going to change it as a 9,000, right? Now here you will be notice that now the button should be edit, right? It's automatically change it as a edit, right? If you click the edit button, right, add and edit both are doing at the same button as well, right? Now if you click it here, edit, right, if you click this button, now the record should be updated here, update, click OK. Now here, for all the forms should be clear here, button should be become as a save, right? Now if you refresh it, you will be able to see the record here, C#.net, right, 9,000, right, perfect, right? Now if you want to delete the record, what you are going to do is here, click delete button. This record you will be able to delete, want to delete, click delete button, delete it, right? Now if you refresh it here, data deleted successfully, right? A very simple system, how to do step by step I'll be teach, right? Now let's close the application, right? Now what I'm going to do is here, first I'm going to go to the file, new project. Here choose Visual C# Windows application. You can name the program here, right? I just named the program as student registration, REG registration system, right? Okay, now here you will be able to browse and give the path where the project want to save, right? I just give the same path, right? It's no problem, right? Here click OK. Now your new project is creating now, right? It's created successfully. This is the blank form. I am going to design the form right here. First what I am going to do is here, I have to increase the size of the form little bit here. First what I am going to do is here, first you have to set the start position, right? If you run this application, you will be see it is starting default, it choose the default location and run the application, right? I want to run the application at the center of the screen. So how to set is, select this form, right click properties. Here this is the property window of the C#.net. Here this all the properties you can manage here. I want to go to the property start position. Start position here, it's defaultly come as Windows default location, select as a default location. I'm going to change it as a center screen, right? If you make it as a center screen and start run here, it start at the center of the screen, right? Simple, right? Now let's close it. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to design the form. So let's go to the toolbox at your left side. Here first I am going to drag one label on the form here, right? Here right click properties, here I am going to change this one as a student registration, right? Press enter key and apply the text, Right. After that, right click properties. Go to the font property, this one, click here. Bold, we have to change this one as a 26, right, 26, click OK. Right, perfect. The size should be perfect, right. After that, what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to drag one group box. So go to the toolbox. So have to drag one group box on the form here. First, what I'm going to do is here, select the group box, right click properties. Here we go to the text. So change it as a text, we have to change it as student registration. Press enter key and apply the text. And if you want to increase the font size little bit, select the font size, you have to change it as a 10, click OK. Right, perfect. After that, what I'm going to do is here, we have to drag the labels, toolbox, and drag the labels. Right, now here we have to arrange it. Right, now here select the label, right click properties, we have to change this one as a student name, this one we have to change it as a course, this one we have to change it as a, this label you have to change it as a fee. Right, now what I am going to do is here, drag three text boxes for this label. So go back to my toolbox and drag three text boxes, double click, double click, double click. Right, if you double click you can get one, if you double click can get two, if you double click can get three. Right, this one you can get the text boxes. Right, you have to arrange the sizes look like this. Right, perfect. Right, okay, perfect. Now what I am going to do is here, I need the buttons. So let's back to toolbox and we have to drag three buttons, double click, double click, double click. Right, you have to arrange them. This one should be named, we have to change the name, it name as save. This one you have to change it as delete. This one should be the delete button, like we no need at the delete button, right, only we have to save and clear. Right, okay, perfect. Okay, now what I am going to do is here, I need one data grid view on the right side. So go to the toolbox and get the data grid view. You have to search the letter, right, data grid view mean D, toolbox mean T, text box mean T, you have to search like this so you can easily find the tool, right, button mean B, right, so data grid view D, right, go to the D, right, so here you can get it here. That's the thing you have to write. Do it, right, perfect. Now what I'm going to do is here, after that you have to set the columns, right, student course fee, all the stuff you have to set it here. We have to add the heading, right, header text right here. So first what I'm going to do is here, go to my SQL server, right, SQL server I have installed in my machine, SQL Server 2012 in my computer. The latest version you can download it, Microsoft SQL Server 2016 version, right, I using the oldest version, Microsoft SQL Server 2012, right. So here first I am going to connect it, it's a local machine, so I have put dot. After that authentication I have to select as SQL authentication. Authentication we are set while installing the SQL server, you can set it here, right? While installing the SQL server, you have to set the SQL authentication, right? Login SSH, password I have gave while installing admin 123, right? This is the password I gave while I installing the SQL Server 2012, right? Now click connect button. It's connected successfully. Now here it's connected successfully. Right click, you can check properties. Right here, this is the information. Right. Now what I'm going to do is here. Let's click OK. Now here, this is the database folder. Now we here we will be able to create the database on this folder. So we have to expand the database. These are the database I have created. Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to create the new database. So here, right click, new database. So here I'm going to create as, right here I'm going to just give the name as database name. I'm going to GCBT, right? GCBT. I just give the name as GCBT, right? Database name GCBT. I'm going to give click OK, right? GCBT mean like a school. I just use simple sample name. GCBT mean the school name, right? So here school. So here we have to expand it inside the data GCBT database. Inside the database we have a table. This table I'm going to create the table, right? So here select this folder, right click, new table. Here I'm going to give the columns names first. So first ID column, data type integer. You have type integer. A little bit slow, right? Okay, now here after that go to below property of this data type. Here you have to set the auto incremented part, right? Auto increment part, you have to here come down here, identify specification. You have to select this one, you have to expand it. There will be the property is identity, default come as no. You have to change it as a yes mean it is incremented by one. Here you can see below by one mean it is incremented by one. Once you add the record, ID should be one. Once again you have to add the record, ID should be two, right? It's keep on incremented. Okay, after you insert the records, right? So after that what I'm going to do is you have to write the student name, ST name. This one should be the data type varchar. After that course, this one should be we have to varchar. After that fee, this one should be int, right? After that you have to make this one as a primary key. ID field, right click and set primary key, right? So primary key is unique. You have to put it here, right? Now what I'm going to, after done all the stuff correctly, click save button. Here the menu bar, there will be the save button available. Click on this one. It asking to create the table. I'm going to give the name as this one should be the student table, right? Click OK, right? Now you have successfully created the database GCBT. Inside the database you have a table which name is student, right? Okay, this is the stuff you have to create. First you have to create this stuff, right? After done this stuff successfully, back to your C#.net, right? Here now here what I'm going to do is here, first what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to go to the code part. So right click, view code. Here right click, select the form, right click, view code, right? It's a default code, right? Now here we have to write the namespace first, right? So you have to write using system dot data dot SQL client, right? You have to import the namespaces. These are called as namespaces, right? If you are not write this namespace here, you won't be able to access the class of the SQL classes, right? You can't connect the database, right? So after that, what I'm going to do is here, you have to establish a connection, right? SQL connection here. So here we have to write here is, first you have to write here, SQL connection. You have to access SQL connection, right? SQL connection, right? This SQL connection, all the stuff are coming from this namespace, right? Okay, SQL connection. You have to create the object as con equal new SQL connection. You have to write the path here, right? Simply you have to write here is, simply you have to write data source equal, data source equal, what is the data source mean? You don't worry about that, you just go to the database. Simply you have to right click properties, this is my name, PC name, you have just copy this one, you have to write back to here, you have to paste it, right, this is the name, right, you have to paste it here, right, this is the name, what is the, right, this is the way you have to do it. After that, what I am going to do is here, after that you have to write initial catalog, you have to write, this is a database name you have to write, okay. Database name is GCBT. After that, we have to write as a user ID. User ID. User ID is your user ID is SA. Password. While installing the SQL Server 2012, I gave admin 123. That's the password. Right. Okay. Perfect. This is the SQL. You have to establish a connection. You have to write this way, right? After that, what I am going to do is here, we have to write the another stuff is you have to create the SQL command. SQL command, you have to write the SQL command equal SQL command, right? After that, you have to write as a SQL data reader. So, SQL data reader, so SQL data reader, great. After that, we have to write string ID, create the variable string ID variable. After that, bool mode equal to, right. After that, you have to create another variable string SQL. Just right. These are the things we have to write here, right. After that, what I am going to do is here, first I am going to insert the record. This is the connection, all the stuff are correct. First, what I am going to do is here, I am going to insert the records into the database. That is the thing first I am going to do. So first select the save button, right? Double click on this one, right? It goes to the button click event. Now here, first what I am going to do is here, we have to go back to my design. Here first we have to name this text boxes. Select this one, right click properties, go to the name. The default name is come as text box 1. Here we have to change this txt name. You can change s name or anything. I just change it as txt name. Press enter key. After that, this one txt course. Press enter key. After that, select this one. This one should be txt fee. Right, this is the efficient way to change the names, right? Now let's go to the double click the save button. Now here we successfully renamed the text boxes. Now here what I am going to do is here, these text boxes I am going to assign to the variables. So here first I am going to write the variable string name. I am going to create the variable as name. Variable name, this is a data type string. Here I am going to first assigning to this text box, right? Okay, so we have to type txt name dot text, right? When the user enter the student name on this text box, is assigned to the variable name, right? Now same thing you have to do the course as well. Txt course dot text. After that, string fee equal txt fee dot text. Right, this is the thing we have to do. Right, now what I am going to do is here, after that here there will be the, I have created the variable bool mode, right? This is the variable name mode equal true, right? This is a boolean type variable. So here what I create this variable is, if the mode is true mean, we have to add the record. If the mode is false mean, it's update the record, right? So here I just wrote the command and mention here, if the mode is true mean, add the records, otherwise update the record, right? Okay, I just write it here, right? If the mode is true mean, add the record, otherwise update the record, right? So here if I write, if mode, it will be mode, this mode equal true mean, you have to write here is insert code, right? Otherwise you have to write the else part. This is write the update code, right? Now first what I am going to do is here, I am going to write the insert code. I have already created the variable SQL variable here. So you have to write SQL equal, right? What is the table you are going to insert the record? So first we have to open the SQL Server 2012, right? It's connected successfully. Right, our database here, our database is GCBT. I have created the database GCBT. This is here, right? So here we have to click this plus sign to expand it. This is a table, right? Student table. Right click, you have to here select top 100, drop it, right? These are the columns available, ID, ST, name, course, fee, right? There are no records available here because I haven't added the records, right? So first what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to write the insert code, right? So you have to write insert into which table you are going to insert the record? Student table, right? What is the name of the table? Name? It's a student. Okay, this is the name of the table, right? Student, right? You have to write the name properly, student, right? Student. After that you have to write the values. So we have to write like this. What is the value? You have to write like this: ST name, course fee, right? What you type here, the same name you have to write here as well. Okay, this is coming from the table columns, right? Database table columns. Here you have to write the inner stuff is values. So to insert the value here, we have to write the parameter, right? So here we have to write parameters, the same thing here to copy. Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. You have to put the parameter type, right? Like this, right? Perfect. This is the thing you have to write first. After that, what I am going to do is here, we have to open the connection, con.open, right? Perfect. After that, what I am going to do is here, we have to write the, we already created the command, SQL command. Object, you have to get it here, SQL command equal new SQL command. Here we have to write here is a, we have to test both query and connection, both are working, right? Query first is a, if the query is working, and here check connection is working. If both worked successfully, now after that we have to set it to the parameter. So here parameters dot add value with, you have to write here is simply, you have to write first thing is this one, ST name, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here, comma this name, right? Okay, if you type the user type on this text, it's assigned to the variable name. This name you are passing here, it adding to the relevant columns, right? It goes here, it's put into the relevant column like this, right? So that's how it's at the record. So but it is not error here, we forgot to put the colon mark. This is a parameter, right? Perfect. Now let's same thing, you have to Control C to copy, Control V to paste below, right? This is the way to, you have to write. Second thing is course, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. This one should be the course. Same thing, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here, fee, right? Right, these are the variables, right? These are the parameters, right? After that, this all the success, we have to show the message simply. Message box dot show, you have to write here is a message, you have to pass it, record it. Right. After that, you have to write cmd dot execute non query. Right, that's the thing you have to write. After that, what I am going to do is here, we have to clear the text boxes. So you have to write txt name dot clear, right? After that, the record, we have to clear the text box. After that, you have to clear course, control c to copy, control v to paste here, right? These things you have to clear. After clear all the stuff, we have to the cursor should be focused on the txt name text box, right? Dot focus, you have to call the focus method, right? That's the thing you have to write. Okay, now let's check whether it's working fine or not, right? This is the thing you have to write at the end. We have to close the connection, con dot close, right? That's the thing you have to write. Now let's check. Here, what is the problem? Intel catalog, right? There, the problem is Intel catalog. There's a wrong. It's mentioning. Problem is here, catalog, CATA, right? So that's a problem. I put T, right? You have to put A. Okay, that's a problem, right? Now here it's working fine. Now I'm going to add the record. First, I'm going to add the record as student name John. Course, I'm going to enter as Java. Fee, I'm going to enter as 10,000. Right, let's check. Click save button. Record added. Perfect. Now here, its form should be clear and focus on the cursor should be focused on the student name text box. It's working fine. Now let's check on the database whether it's working fine or not. Select the table. Right click. Select the table. Right click. Select top. Here it's working fine. Record is added perfectly. Right. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is here, let's close the application here. Now let's do the another stuff is we have to, after add the records, we have to load the records into the table. This is the thing we have to write. Okay, so first what I'm going to do is select the data grid view, click the arrow here, click add columns. Here first I'm going to add the relevant columns, right? So here header text first one should be the ID, student ID, click add. Second one should be the student name. Third one should be the course, click add. After that fee, we have to add the fee, click add. After that we have to add the additional two columns. First one should be the edit. Here type, we have to change it as a data grid view text box column. This is not text box column. You have to change it as a data grid view button columns, right? This is the button, right? If you want to edit the record, click on this button and you will be able to edit the record, right? So click it, right? After that, we have to add another one is a delete, right? Data grid view, this also the same option, button column, right? That perfect. Now let's close it, right? Now you can check. You can check here. Got to expand the right. Delete and edit. Right. Perfect. Now what I'm going to do is here. Again, click on this one. Edit columns. You have to change a couple of changes here. Edit button. Click on this one. Here, you have to enable this one. You have to text. You have to give here is edit. Press enter key. Right. When you load the record, here edit delete button will be show. Here you have to make the text edit this button. After that, here use column text button value, it defaultly come as false. You have to enable it as true, right? This is the thing you have to do, right? After that, here data grid view cell style, click on this one. you can change the font font type anything here. So I just change the font right like this, the same thing, bold, right, click OK, perfect. The same thing you have to do the delete as well, click on the delete button. Here also text we have to type delete. After that, use column text for button values, it defaultly come as false, you have to enable that too. Then only the text would be work, right. Now here we have to font also you can change. Here font we have to change it as the same font. Arial bold color 10, right, click OK. OK, perfect. Click OK, perfect, right. This is the thing we have to do, right. Right. Now let's what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to load the table. Here this is the record we have to load on the table. So let's back to our code, click on this one code back, right. Here I'm going to create the separate function. Here you have to write public void load. Here we have to write here is, first we have to write the try block, so write a catch. Right, here we have to write, first inside the try we have to write, we already create the SQL variable above here. Now first you have to write the query SQL equal select all from which table you are going to load the record, student table I am going to load the record. We have to write this command, new command, you have to write SQL comma con. After that we have to write here connection dot open, we have to dr not dr read, right, not SQL data reader, right, read. So you write read, so here sorry you have to write here said read equal, you have to write command dot reader execute reader, here you have to call this one execute reader, right. After that what I am going to do is here, I am going to write the data adapter. We have to, what is the data adapter, so write here is SQL data adapter DRR, right. So we have to write here is DRR equal new SQL data adapter, so write SQL comma connection, you have to use here, that's the thing you have to write. Okay, perfect. Right, now what I am going to do is here, you have to write, first you have to clear the things, right. First you have to write data grid view, what is the name of the data grid view, this is the data grid view name, right, this is the name data grid view one. Control C to copy, Control V to paste here, dot, first we have to clear the rows, you have to write rows dot clear. After that what I am going to do is here, we have to write while dr dot read mean this, I am going to read this one SQL data reader, here read function dot read, we have to call the predefined read function, right. After that what I am going to see, we have to write here is we have data grid view 1, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here, dot rows dot add, so we have to write here is dr, you have to write first one dr sorry read, not dr read, read mean this read, okay, you have to call it here read. Your criteria is zero position mean id, the same thing you have to write again, Control C to copy, Control V to paste here, second one should be, first one should be name, after that to mean name. After that, free mean this free mean this one. So to three mean course, right? Four mean right. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. This is the thing we have to log, right? This one should be ID, student name, course fee, right? That's the thing we have to log, right? So here we have to log that, right? That's the thing. Okay, simple. Now what I'm going to do is we have to close the connection. Con.close. Right. Perfect. Right. We no need the SQL data adapter. Right. We no need it. Only we load from the reader only. Right. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is here. If there is any error, you can. Error should be throw here. Right. So we have right here is message box. Dot show. Here right here is ex dot message. Right. Now let's check the load function. Control C to copy. You have to call it when the form is initialized here. Compound. Right. Initial after the initialization compound. Right. Okay. Now let's run and check. Here it's working perfectly. Here it's working perfectly. Here edit button and delete button, right? Here additional row will be displayed here. What I'm going to do is here select this one and here go to the property, select the data grid view, go to the property here, allow the user to add the row. Here you have to make it as false, then it will be not enable. Here when you run it, here there will be two buttons, edit and delete button. If you want to edit the record, click on this button. If you want to delete the record, click on this button. Perfect, right? This is an efficient way to do the program, right? Now let's do the another stuff is if you click edit button, the selected row record should be passing to the form, right? So let me see how to do the task. Okay, let's go to the code part. After the load function, the function is started here, closing here. Now what I'm going to do is here I'm going to create another function, public function. Public void get id, right? Here we have to pass one parameter id, string parameter id, right? Now here what I'm going to see, we have to write the SQL, this one SQL query, control C copy, control D basically same thing. We have to write additional code here, student where id equal, you have to write here is this id. So you have to write single quotation, double quotation, single quotation, double quotation, double quotation, single quotation. Inside here we have to write two plus sign. Here we have to put the id variable here. You have to call the id variable here, right? Okay, when the user click on this edit button, the id should be goes here, right? That's the thing I have to do here, right? So what I'm going to do is here after that, we have to write here is we have to write command, SQL command. We have to write new SQL command, SQL con, right? Here you have to write SQL data reader. We have to already written the SQL data reader object here. After that what I am going to do is you have to open the con.open, open the connection. You have to write here is after that you have to call the data reader here, the same data reader you have to call. Control C copy, read, right. Read SQL data reader, right. After that what I am going to do is here, I am going to same you have to write as a loop, right, while read dot read function. Here we have to write, first we have to, when the users click on the edit button, the selected record should be passing to the form, right? So here what I'm going to do is here we have to write text box name, txt name dot text equal passing the values read. So here first one should be passing as a name. So one dot read, dot to string. Right. Okay. Name should be the position of zero. Okay. ID is not passing here. There are no text boxes. Anyway. Name should be passing here. Post passing here. Fees should be passing to the relevant text boxes. Right. Fee. Right. After that, we have to the same thing. Control C to copy. Control V to paste here. Second one should be txt course. What's the name? So here we have to write the name so properly, right? Second one should be txt course, right? Dot text equal read to dot to string, right? Third one should be txt fee dot text equal read 3 dot to string. Right, perfect. Now finally we have to close the connection, con dot close. After that what I am going to do is here, get id function, we are passing one argument. So here this id should be coming from the data grid view. So this id, right? So what I am going to do is here this is the data grid view. You have to double click on this. It is goes to the data grid view cell content click, right? If you click the cell, right, if you click edit button along with the id should be goes to this parameter and it get it here, and relevant record should be shown in the this form, right? That's the thing I have to do. So double click on this data grid view cell content. Here we have to write this code, very simple. If e mean this, right, e dot, you have to write column index double equal data grid view one dot columns to dot columns. Columns, you have to write edit, right? So here first what I am going to select this one, click this button, add column, here this one, edit columns, not add columns, edit columns, click on this one. If you give the proper name, right, edit, you have to give the name here, this one should be edit, you have to give the name also edit, press enter key. This one should be delete, right, you have to give the name here, delete. So you will be able to write the name here, delete, right. Press enter key to apply, right? Once you change this, press enter key on your keyboard to apply, right? This also edit, right? Click OK. Then only you have to write here the name. Name should be important, right? So okay, this one should be edit. So I have changed the edit. If you click the edit button, I show here column index, data grid view, columns, edit column dot index. Here we have called and sign, you have to write e dot row index greater than equal 0. We have to write here is, what I am going to write here is mod false mean mod true mean add the record, mod false mean update the record, right? You have to understand the concept, right? Mod false. Now what I am going to do is here get the id equal this id, the id equal, you have to write passing to data grid view 1 dot column current row dot cell 0 position dot value dot to string. That's the thing we have to do. After that, we have to write throw the get id function, right? Id, what's the id here selected, right? I already create the id variable above, just string like this variable above. I get the id here, right? When the user select the edit button, the relevant column zero mean zero position mean this id. What is the id of this particular record? When the user click edit button, what is the relevant id should be passing to this variable. If you this variable, this id should be passing to this argument, it's calling this function along with the id. So it goes to the this relevant function here, put into the id, what is the relevant database record, it show on the form, right? Now let's check whether it's working fine or not. Click edit button here, its relevant record should be displayed here. Okay, if you click, its relevant record should be displayed here. Perfect, right? Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to write the edit code for that, right? How to edit the record, right? So let's run the things, right? So here first what I'm going to do is we have to close it. I successfully display, double click on the save button here. If it is false, it goes to the else part for edit. So how to write the edit code? So you have the same code, we have to copy same insert code, control C to copy, control V to paste below else part. So here I am going to write, here is simple, you have to write here only the, we have to change the code, this one should be, we have to change it as update student table set. So I'll write first write student, right? St name equal, sorry, student name equal, you have to write simply control C to copy, control V to paste here. You have to write here is comma, you have to write here course, second should be name should be course equal the same thing, this course, control C to copy, control V to paste here, this one should be the course, after that comma, after that fee equal the same thing, you have to copy, control C to copy, control V to paste here, this one should be fee, where we have to write where id equal id, right? That's the thing we have to write. Okay, now here what the thing we have to put, the thing is this id, right? When the person click on this id, he have to get it here as well, you have to get it here, the same thing, the same id, what is the, when the user click a particular record, the id should be stored in this variable. So the same thing, you have to control C to copy, you have to get it here for update purpose, you have to get it the id here. For update the record, right, you have to get the id here. So update, get the id, this id, you have to control C, you have to, this one we no need it, we have to get the third thing is the id, control C to copy, control V to paste here, this one should be id, this one should be id, right? Other things are same, right? Student name, same thing here, name we have to already, they are here created here, so name, second one should be the course, third one should be the fee, this one should be the id, right? Here this one should be record updated, right? This how we easily do the task, right? Okay, now let's check whether it is working fine or not. All the stuff are correct. Now let's check, right? Now here when you execute the code, if you click edit button, successfully here display Java programming, programming course is, I'm going to change it as a 12,000, click save button, record updated, click OK. It's not loaded here. Now I'm going to refresh the form, you have to put the refresh button. So let's go here, it's working fine. If you again load here, it's working fine, it's updated successfully, record should be updated successfully. Now here we have to put one thing, let's back to our code. Here when you select the row here, go to the here, this one data grid view cell content, click here. Here we have to do it another one thing, button one, button one means this is the button one, we have to this one, we have to text, we have to change it as a edit, right? When you click this one content click, right? After edit the record, what I'm going to do is here the same thing, control C to copy, you have to this one, you have to change it as a, after edit the record, this edit the record, right? After edit the record, you call it here, this one should be simply change it as a save, right? After that, we have to do another thing is a mod. After edit the record, we have to mod equal, we have to make it as true. We have to make it as true, right? After edit the record, right? This is the thing we have to do right here. Simply, you have to execute the program and check. The user simply understand that stuff here. When you click edit button, it simply button should be displayed as here edit, right? If you edit the record, click edit button, record updated successfully here. Now it simply change it as save, right? It's working perfectly. It's working perfectly, right? Perfectly it's working, right? Now what I'm going to see, I'm going to do the another stuff is important stuff is the delete code, delete button code. I'm going to add another record. For here simply we have to add another record. This one should be here, right? Here is Peter cost C sharp 15,000. Click save, record added, right? Now here I want to do the refresh code as well. Here I'm going to put the refresh button as well. So here you have to put the refresh button. Double click on this one, the same load. This load function, control C to copy, double click on this function, you have to paste it. Right. Now you can reload it, right? If you enter another record and cost VB fee 10,000, click save, record added. Refresh it here, it refreshes successfully. If you click edit button, it's added here, it's working successfully, right? So it's perfectly it's working, right? If you click clear the record, it should clear. If you want to clear all the stuff, so here we have to clear button also. We have to write the code for that. Simply go to the save button, the same code for clear, the same update code we have to clear. Right, control C to copy the same thing. You have to clear, you have to paste it here, right? Okay, if all the stuff we need to clear, right? First button should be saved, here all the stuff should be clear, right? Okay, we have to clear here. If you click here, if you accidentally click this button, how to clear the record, click clear, it's all the stuff should be clear. Perfect, right? Now what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to do another one thing is a delete button only. We have to write the code for that. If you click delete button, record should be deleted, right? So it's simply write here table content click. If after that you have to write a else part, else if you have to write again the we have to write the else if code. So the same code you have to control C copy, control to paste below. Here we have to write else. Here we have to write open bracket and close bracket. Here we have to write this one should be the delete. So here we have to write same thing, mod equal the same code. Right, mode this all the stuff are same. Control C to copy, control V to paste here. Finally, you have right here con dot connection. Sorry, not here. Right, connection. Now here we have to write the SQL code. SQL equal. You have to write the delete code. Delete from student. The table name student where ID mean this ID. So this this table ID, this table this ID equal into out right here is out right like this. Okay, perfectly out right like this. Simply out right. After that you write connection dot open the connection. We simply out right here cmd equal new SQL command. We have to make it as connection SQL query connection. We have to check it. After that, we have to write as a cmd dot parameter dot add value with. We have to write here this one. This one should be the ID. This parameter ID. Control C to copy. Control V to paste. Comma this ID. But this ID was selected. This ID. Right. Perfect. Right. After that, we have to calling the cmd dot execute non query. You have to call it here, right? After that you have to pass the message message box dot show. You have to write simple. You have to write here is you have to write record deleted. Right, record deleted. Finally, we have to close the connection. Right. Okay. This how we can delete the record. Right. Selected record should be passed into the this ID. We have to write the SQL statement for the delete statement. After that, kind of check the query and connection. If this all the stuff are fine, here this one should be the here. This one should be the ID. This one should be the parameter. We have to equal int here. So after that, we have to call the execute. Non-query to execute this queries. After that, get the message delete. Right. So let's back. Let's run and check. Now I am going to this delete this record. Click on this record. Why? What's the problem? Additional syntax error. Right. The problem is here. Delete from table where? Here we are. Problem is ID. We didn't write the ID column here. That's a problem. Right. Now it's okay. Click delete button. Record deleted. If you refresh it, it's working fine. Right. If you delete this record, delete it. If you refresh it, it's working fine. Right. It's working fine. Okay. It's been deleted successfully. The earlier the problem is I didn't there ID columns. I have to miss it. That's the problem. Right. Okay. I hope you guys you understood the C# simple project well. If you have any doubt on this, you can ask me anytime. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.